say something about the Muslims these days.
Subhanallah,
as if Hillary Clinton is the Mahdi al-Muntadhar.
The Muslims are so upset because Hillary did not win, as if Hillary is the Mahdi that we're waiting for. I don't know what's going on with the brothers and the sisters. You know, listen, we understand the they call it the pros and cons of both. And you tried, but it didn't work. And it's sounding like, you know, Donald Trump got into office beyond Allah's will, as if Allah did not will it, and Donald Trump like challenged Allah. Wallahi, this is how it's sounding. وَالْعَيَدُ بِاللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ. Allah is the owner of al-mulk, of the kingship. تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. You bestowed, at least يعني in this country, يعني we have to give them this, that they get it through some sort of يعني relatively legitimate process. يعني other people, they get it forcefully. In other parts of the world, it's still within Allah's will, Allah's decree, Allah's decree. But Allah willed for him to become the president. تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ. And you take the kingship from whomever you will. وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. And يعني you honor, dignify whom you will. وَتُذِلُّ, you humiliate, boot down whom he wills. مَنْ تَشَاءُ. Look at this at the end. What? بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ. All of this is khayr. The fact that he given the kingship to this one and took it away from this one, dignified this one, humiliated this one, it's all what? Khayr. And I told you the story before, and I have to tell it to you just to restore that belief in al-Qadr. You know that king who had a minister, a king and a minister. The minister is the type who believes in al-Qadr. قضاء الله وقدره. For one day, the king is messing around with a knife. He cut his finger. For the minister said, خير إن شاء الله. This is good إن شاء الله. رجل بليف يعني ما. For the king got upset and he said, what good in me cutting my finger? Take him to jail. Put him in jail. Arrest him. So they arrested him. He was placed in jail. So in his way to jail, he said, what? خير إن شاء الله. It's good إن شاء الله. There is goodness in this one too إن شاء الله. It was the habit of the king and minister that every week they go out to hunt and have a nomad kind of lifestyle. Of course, he doesn't have his minister. The minister used to be the one who leads his way. He doesn't have him this time. For he got lost in the jungle. He got arrested by a group of Bedouin who used to worship idols. And it happens that this day they are supposed to offer a qurbani, a human qurbani, to their idol. He said, we will not find anyone better than this guy. He's dressed so nice. I mean, he's the qurbani right here. But they looked at his hand. They found him missing a finger. They said, astaghfirullah. We offer a qurbani like this to our God. Get out of here. You're not even good to be a qurbani. For he was spared. In his way back to the palace, he started reflecting upon the statement of the king, saying, now I understand why the minister said it's good that I lost my finger, because would I have that finger, I would have been slaughtered by now. So immediately when he arrived at his palace, he requested the release of the minister. He said, listen, I understood why you said khair, but what is good in you going to jail? He said, would I have been with you on that journey, I would have been the qurbani. So it's all good. This is the style of iman. This is, ya ikhwa, the asset of faith. This is what faith provides for a believer that no one else can give. قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. What? What's wrong with us?